Hey guys, Silver Game of Thrones with here. So I was thinking about this video a long time, and today I have some kind of feeling. Okay, let's do it today. So this video I will try to show the difference between this, between tangible asset, and between this, okay, between fear. And let's see if I have succeed to do this. You let me know. So let's say you are like serious man, you know, you like everyone from us, right? He tried to find out, you know, what is the best bet, where I can put my money, you know, cash, like everyone. I also try to use different areas, you know, real estate, you know, 401k, stock market, you know, this cryptocurrency, you know, everyone tried different ways, right? But as more I was looking into all this area, as more I start to understand that the tangible asset like silver and gold should be very important part of your portfolio, especially today, when we have this, you know, Fed printing money like crazy, this should be very important part of your portfolio. Maybe 10, maybe 15%. It's everyone has different opinion on this. But let's say you pay your debt, because if you don't pay your debt, you know, then nothing to talk about. It's not relevant for you. You need to pay your debt first. So you pay your debt, and then you start to accumulate, you know, some cash into your saving account. Let's say you have saving account, you accumulate your cash. And when you accumulate cash on your saving account, you just watch how your money are sinking down, you know, how your money are disappear, because, you know, saving your cash in a bank give you nothing, right? Before, I remember, like, it was 3%, and then 2.5%. Today it's going to be negative, right? So you're going to pay to bank, then they hold money for you. You understand how funny it is? So, you know, let's say you finally, you know, understood that you need to accumulate a real tangible asset. You start to accumulate silver and gold, and everything is good, everything is fine. But I think everyone from us, you know, start this question. Okay, I am, you know, accumulating. Do I need to continue? Is it not enough? Maybe it's enough already, right? Maybe I need to stop and, you know, I just, you know, keep accumulating cash. So let's see what is different. What is different between this, you know, between a currency and between tangible asset? So yeah, let's say you have both, okay? And you look on your, you know, tangible assets. This is the federal note, right? This is $100 federal note, okay? So you know that you go to shop and you must to have this $100, okay? In any, it can be cash or it can be credit card. It doesn't matter, but we pay with the dollar, okay? And let's compare this, you know, whatever we have fiat currency we have with the silver. So let's say, I put here different notes like $1, $10, $100. And first of all, I want to ask you, do you think there is a difference between $1 and $100? Do you think there is a value difference in $1 and $100? No, there is no value difference in $1 and $100. The boss to produce these two notes cost the same effort, the same amount of paper, same amount of electricity. It cost probably 15 cents for one note like this. So, you know, it's the same value now, the $10, $1. It's a piece of paper, right? So why people know that this note 100 more times more expensive than this note? Because it has 100. It's mathematically, it has 100, it's 100 times than $1, right? So, okay, mathematically we have it. But there is some real value behind this 100? No. You know, if tomorrow government say, oh, you know what, we exchange it, $100 will cost 100 times more than $100. Okay, we'll use $100, $100 times more than $100, right? It's all in belief. It's all how I believe or how they teach me, you know, to believe that this has 100 times more value than this. But is there any real value behind this? Two notes, you know, take some 300 old notes, you know, they have zero value today. It's only, you know, like historical value. No, it's only what we believe. Okay, so let's say tomorrow, government print $1 million. Okay, this is fake, this is not real, but let's say they print $1 million. It will be different between 1 million and 100? No, it will be no different. It's only, it will be because inflation, because now we use 100, but $100 inflation eats the power, the purchase power of $100, and we need to use $1 million now today. So let's compare this to this. Okay, so you accumulated, let's say you accumulated 5 coins, okay, maple leaf, okay? So you accumulated 5 coins like this, okay? You have 5 coins and it costs $100, right? So 5 coins cost $100 today. So you accumulated your wealth, your purchase power in 5 coins and it costs $100 today. So what will happen tomorrow if government will continue print this dollar and they will be denominated into 1 million? So do you think that tomorrow this $1 million will give you more in silver? No, it will be the same 5 coins. The same 5 coins which you have today, which cost $100, okay? It cost $100, it costs $1 million tomorrow. You understand? This is the difference between tangible assets and between this paper assets. They can add as many zeros as they can and it will have the same or less purchase power. But they cannot change this, because think like this: if today you want to buy silver on $1 million, so it will be 50,000 ounces. 50,000 ounces of, you know, it is like one and a half ton of silver in $1 million. You understand? It's a normal amount of silver you need to in $1 million. But if tomorrow $1 million, the purchase power will be the same as $100, right? So you basically lose all your money which you put into your saving account. This costs zero because, you know, it will be denominated in $1 million. Okay. But if you have the same 5 coins, okay, or the same stack of silver which you accumulated, you know, with help of, your currency, it will have the same purchase power, guys. This is the difference. Your money will disappear in bank account because it will be denominated, okay? And new money will come in. $1 million, they're like in Zimbabwe. Look in Venezuela. They have $1 million, you know. Not $1 trillion they have, trillion. But let's say it will be $1 million will replace this coin, right? So this coin will gone. It will cost nothing. It will be paper. It will be more expensive than paper that printed cents, right? Because $1 million will came, you know, $100,000 million will came. But silver will hold its value, and the same $100 today you store it in silver will be reflected in $1 million. So you take your 5 coins, you exchange on $1 million, and you go grocery store and you buy whatever you want. Whatever you can buy today in $100, you buy tomorrow in $1 million. You understand the difference? You know, everyone need to do this exercise, you know, one time, you know, in a year, probably, just to understand why we guys stack silver and why we are strong stuck in silver and why we think it will save our ass. You know, there is no bullshit in this side, okay? But there are a lot of bullshit on this side, okay? Because it's all fake, guys. This is all fake. It's all fake store of wealth. It is temporary. We use it temporary. As far as we believe in this, as far as everything okay, as far as everything happy, then yeah, you go and use it. But something happened tomorrow as it's crashing today. You see all these riots and all this, you know, pandemic crap going on, okay? The value of this is going to go down like a sinking ship. And it will go into this number. They will start to add zeros like crazy. But who cares? You have this. You protect it, guys. You protect it, okay? This is power, okay? This is not. This is the temporary instrument to exchange it on some you know, foods or some, you know, some whatever you need. But this is stay. It was here, it stay with us, and it will stay much, much longer than you think, okay? So this was my lesson, guys. I hope you enjoy, you know, a little bit education and, you know, in some funny silver. And please put your comments and say what you think. I think we, as silver community, gold and silver community, we are proud that we store our wealth in such beautiful bricks, right? Beautiful bricks, okay? We can give it to our kids, we can give this to our generations, okay? And we don't need any regulation. We don't need any crap telling you, oh, you need to wear mask, you need to go there, you need to do this, you know, because if you don't do this, you are done, okay? So it's just for us, it's additional instrument, okay, to have freedom, to have liberty, to be more independent. Because when they start to print these guys, you will see, when they start going crazy with all this money, will be, you know, helicopter of money, you know, printed, oy, okay? And if you don't have these securities, if you don't have it, guys, you are in big trouble. This was my message, guys, okay? And there is no bullshit in my message.
Bullshit in oil too.
It's everything very serious, okay? Thank you very much, guys, for watching and enjoy. Bye-bye.